everyone, it's Haley, and today I'm going to be doing my March TBR. So I'm giving myself a little bit of what I consider a smaller TBR for this month. I did really, really well in February, but I also didn't do that well in my midterms. So I need to kind of like slow down my reading and pay more attention to school. So that's why I'm kind of giving myself a smaller TBR. So I have 8 books on my TBR, not including my school books and not including the books that I'm currently reading. So let's get into it. So I'm going to start with the books that I'm currently reading. I might end up finishing these in February. I'm not really sure yet. You guys will see when I do my wrap up. So the first one is one that I'm reading for school, and that is Ariel by Sylvia Plath. This is a bind up, I don't know, it's a compilation of a bunch of her poems, and this is like the restored edition, so it has like, it has like the original typewritten ones that she did, and it also has some that have like her little corrections written in, if I can find an example. Yeah, see, so it has like stuff like that in it, so it's pretty cool. I've only read a couple of the poems in here. This shouldn't take me too long, so I'll probably be able to finish this in February unless I get distracted. I have to have it read for March 4th, so I might get distracted before then, but we'll see. I did like the poems I have read so far. I haven't read Sylvia Plath before. I feel like a failure as an English major because English majors are absolutely, at least the ones I go to school with, are absolutely obsessed with Sylvia Plath, and I don't really know that much about her. Like, I know the obvious things, but I don't know that much and I haven't read her before, so I'm excited to get into her poetry, and then I may end up reading some of her novels soon. This next book is one that I just kind of picked up on a whim, and that is Champion by Marie Lu. This is the final book of the Legend trilogy, and I read the second book, Prodigy, last month, and I just really enjoyed it. So I just had to, after that ending, I had to pick up the third book, and I figured why not just finish the whole thing off and add another series to my finished series. So I'm hoping to finish this soon. I'm on page 57 right now, so I'm not really sure if I'm going to be able to finish it before the end of the month. Like, it's highly probable that I will, but then also that I won't, so I don't really know. And the last book that I'm currently reading is one that I really have no idea if I'm going to be able to finish before the end of February, and that is Crown of Midnight by Sarah J. Maas. These books take me forever to read. I don't know why, but it just takes me like a really, really long time to read these. I've been reading this one for a week, kind of off and on now, and it's not that I'm not enjoying it, it just takes me a really long time to get into, and I'm on page 120 after like a week. Usually after a week, I'm done the book. I did have other books that I was reading though, so I'm hoping to finish Snow Like Ashes today or tomorrow, and then I'm going to entirely focus on this one. Well, entirely focus on midterms, but then when I'm gonna read for fun, I'm going to focus on this one because I really just want to finish it. Not that it's not good, I just want to see what happens. So now I'm just gonna briefly talk about the books that I'm reading for school. So the first one is 419 by Will Ferguson. I'm going to take this out of the library, or I might order it on Book Outlet. I'm not really sure yet, but either way, I'm going to be listening to it on audiobook and then just reading along, so then I can just like, I can get through it faster. So I'm reading this for my Canadian literature course, and all I really know about it is that Will Ferguson is normally a comedic writer, but this is his adventure novel, so I'm pretty interested to see how it is because a lot of people really like this book, and I'm excited. So then I have a couple of novels to read for the gender and literature course that I'm taking, that I'm reading the Sylvia Plath book for, and the first one is Leak by Kate Hargreaves. This is just, they're all compilations of poetry. This one was published last year, I believe, and I think this is the author that my prof knows and is going to come into our class, which should be pretty cool. But I was flipping through the poetry in here, and like, look at this one. This is what I have to do as an English major. How do you even analyze that? Oh god. And then this next one is Recyclopedia by Harriet Mullen. This is another just kind of abstract poetry book. I'm not really looking forward to reading these so much because I'm not that big of a fan of abstract poetry, so I don't know. We shall see. and the final two books I have to read for school. I think I may have put on my February TBR, but I don't really remember. But that is Mouse Volume 1 and Volume 2 by Art Spiegelman. These are just graphic novels. I have to read them for the course I'm taking that focuses on the Holocaust. So I have read them before, so it's going to be a reread for me, but I'll probably just read these like the day before we're studying them in class, because they take like 2 seconds since they're graphic novels. Not actually 2 seconds, more like an hour or two. But still, you get the point. Okay, so now we're finally on to the books that I'm going to be reading for fun. This first book is one that I included in a recent book haul, and you guys were so mad at me for not having read it yet, so I decided to put it on my TBR for this month. I'm not sure if I will end up reading this month, because I'm not really sure if I'm in the mood for it, but it's there, and I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But that book is Vampire Academy by Rochelle Mead. So yeah, I have not read Vampire Academy, any of the books. I haven't started the series or anything, and I do want to. I just haven't gotten around to it. There's so many other books. I was still in the mindset that like vampires are stupid after Twilight, so I just never really read it. But I'm going to, hopefully this month. I'm not sure. Like, I don't really feel like I'm in the mood for a vampire book right now. I don't know though, but it is here on my TBR. Maybe it'll happen. I don't know. So the next book is Tease by Amanda Maciel. I was really in the mood to read this after I read Mara Dyer, but I just didn't. I don't remember why, but I didn't. But I do really want to read it. The problem with my TBR this month is I'm not really like super excited for any of the books other than two of them. And I was looking through my bookshelf and thinking of like books that I'd be more excited to read, but I just don't really, there's nothing that I'm really super excited about right now. I don't know why. But yeah, I'm hoping that I will be able to kind of pump myself up to read this. It sounds really interesting. It's about this girl who has committed suicide, and it's, the story is told from the perspective of the girl who bullied that girl into committing suicide. So it seems very interesting. Like, it's gonna be a pretty heavy read, but it should be pretty good. I don't know. I've heard great things, so I'm excited. These next books, I want to read two of them all the way through, and then the one, if I just start it, I will be happy with that. But that is the last three books of the Heroes of Olympus series by Rick Riordan. So book three, Mark of Athena, is the one that I'm on right now, and then House of Hades is book four, and then The Blood of Olympus. So this is the one that I would want to at least get started, but House of Hades and The Mark of Athena, I want to, what was the word? Finish. That's the word. But yeah, I read the first two books in this series, and I have mixed feelings on them. I really loved them. I just don't like how it focuses on different characters for both of the first books. I know that they meet up in Mark of Athena, but I don't really like how that was told, but I'm excited to figure out what happens in the rest of the series. It's building up a lot, and I think it will be really interesting. Rick Riordan can do no wrong, and like, they're always just such sassy characters, and just the writing is fantastic, and so much action. I'm super excited to finish this series and kind of see where it goes. I'm excited to start reading it where they're all together in the book, because that is going to be fantastic. And then the last two books I wanted to talk about are the two that I'm actually very, very excited for. So the first one is All the Right Places by Jennifer Niven. This, you may remember, was on my TBR for last month, but I didn't end up reading it. I just wasn't really in the mood for it, and now I'm going to be reading it with Raylene at Pet Foot and Prong 07. I'm super excited for this book. I have heard nothing but fantastic things about it. Katrina at Little Book Owl absolutely loved it, and her review was really great on it, so I will link that down below. And it was just, I'm so excited for this book. I cannot wait. I'm so pumped to read it. It's gonna be a great time. It's gonna be great. And the last book on my TBR for the month is Red Queen by Victoria Aveyard. When I made my TBR last month, I didn't really take into account new releases or anything, so I didn't end up reading this last month, but I was dying to. I am so excited to read this book. I have heard fantastic things. It has been so anticipated. This was one of my most anticipated books of 2015, and now it is finally here, and I found it actually 4 days before the release date. I found it at Costco, but I couldn't read it because it wasn't on my TBR, and it was really just sad. So now I am so, so pumped to read it. And have you seen the end papers? Because they're beautiful. So those are all the books on my TBR for March. I hope you guys enjoyed, and let me know what you are planning on reading next month in March. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!